Hello, you multi-macros. Ralphie here. Whisky Review 88. And I'm receiving a steady stream of emails from all you folks asking a number of questions, and I must thank you for them because by far the majority are decent, sensible, practical questions, and it is very evident that you're quality people taking an interest in your whisky, and I like that. Now, one of the emails said, Ralphie, I'm in a remote place. I can't buy single malt whiskies. I can only buy blends. Could you review another blend to help me make my purchasing decisions? Well, okay. Here's one I got as a present for helping a friend of mine move house recently. Well, I didn't do much. I just supplied the cardboard boxes and drove the van, but there we go. Anyway, this is what he gave me. A bottle of Chivas Regal, 12-year-old. Few interesting points about Chivas. It is the second largest selling whisky, blended whisky, in the world after Johnny Walker Black Label. And along with Johnny Walker, the two things that they have in common is they were started by licensed grocers many, many moons ago. And in fact, with Chivas Regal, it was Chivas Brothers in Aberdeen, a licensed grocer there, in 1801. So it goes back a fair whack. And it's something that they do mention on this rather individual and distinctive packaging. Now, this is an interesting point. The most successful blended whiskies in the world owe a lot of their success to their highly defined, articulate presentation. Now look at this box, quite unmistakable. It's cardboard, but it's got that metallic look about it. It's got that old fashioned Scottish baronial sort of medieval sort of look with its shields and swords and lions and castles and roses and frankly a little bit of Masonic symbolism as well, and it certainly makes it stand out in the crowd. But how about the taste and the smell of this? There we go. It is typical whisky colour. The colour induced by caramel for shelf recognition. But it is a blend, so that's fine. Most of these whiskies are going to be mixed or put with ice in a tumbler, perhaps Coca-Cola, lemonade, green tea, whatever takes your fancy. But as a malt purist, I shall be nosing and tasting this neat, perhaps with a drop of water. Now, Chivas, just while this opens up, Chivas is owned by Pernod Ricard, who also own Ballantine's, and are the distributors for Havana Club Cuban Rum. I do recommend the 7-year-old Havana Club, very good. And various other brands, including Malibu. And a number of single malt whiskies, which contribute to this blend, including Glenlivet, Aberlour. We do like Aberlour. But also, Chivas own Strathyla, Longmorn, Scapa, Tormore, and Glenburgie. Up until recently, Chivas owned Glendronach, which they sold to a small private craft distiller by the name of Benriach. And I applaud and salute Chivas for that decision, whereas the one of their main competitors would close it has closed a distillery and put it completely beyond use, which is frankly a bit nasty. Chivas have had the good grace and the dignity to sell a working quality distillery to a smaller company so that they could make the most of it, which they are indeed doing. And that is a very professional, commendable decision. Nose. It's whiskey. Okay. There's a slightly yeastiness, barley. Wee touch of oak. A lot of sweetness going on here. Now that sweetness is coming from Strath Isla. If you get to try Strath Isla single malt whiskey on its own, particularly as the 12-year-old, you'll find it is remarkably sweet. It is one of the sweetest of the malt whiskies around. And that makes Chivas quite palatable. Also, it has some pretty good grain whiskey involved in it. It's roughly about 40% malt, 60% grain, and although you tend to hear the malt distilleries get a real big heavy mention when blended whiskies are being talked about, you don't hear so much about you don't hear so much about the grain whiskies, which get used as part of the constructing of these blends. And that's a shame, because in many instances it's the grain involvement, the grain whiskey, which although supposed to be invisible, is in fact positively enhancing and in fact occasionally making a blended whiskey and covering up the wrinkles in some of the malts. In this case, a little bit of herbal touch, fairly ambiguous. Chivas 12-year-old is an ambiguous blend. It's meant to be all about suggestion and being quiet and discreet. It's not in your face. It's not big and bold. You will not find a touch of Isla here. Peat, not really. A pleasant, clean, fizzy, sweet malt arrival. It develops a little bit of dried fruitiness, mainly raisin, and then it promptly disappears. Finish, the sort of finish that you're used to on a single malt, you will not find in this. It's not designed, and it's something worth mentioning, again, that doesn't get much of a mention by the experts, is that we shouldn't really compare grain blended whiskies too directly with single malts, because single malts are specifically about individual character and flavour. Blended whiskies are about adjusting all that, engineering all that away from these intense flavours to something which is going to be acceptable and comfortable for those who are not necessarily that keen on single malts, or have yet to discover and get to know single malts. So if you want to buy a whiskey for someone who doesn't drink whiskey, fine, give them a blend like Chivas. It's readily available, it's not too expensive, it's got that lovely box. And I'll conclude by saying that for an uneventful blend, it's clean enough, it's well-mannered, it's well-behaved, it fulfills its duty admirably. 83 out of 100, and this, of course, is Blend Marks. Now, if you do get to Scotland and visit any of Chivas's single malt distilleries, you will find these on sale. Now, what they've done is they've been a 50 centilitre bottle at cask strength. They're bottling some of their own single malts, which are not generally available. The one I recommend is Glenburgie. I will review this later. It's a cracker. But there you are. Your good health. some soda perhaps, a slice of orange. I'll see you later.